Have you ever wondered why you're not able to speak good English? Have you ever been a part of an interview and beaten yourself up because you weren't able to speak fluent English? Now, at times like these, what do? You quickly go to the internet and you type ways to improve your language. But have you wondered that your don'ts are as important as the do's? Don't worry. In this video, we will be focusing on the don'ts to improve your fluency in the language. Welcome to yet another informative session from English Partner with Sanjana. There are many don'ts that you could be focusing on, but here, let's focus on the top 5 don'ts. Number 1, fear. Don't be afraid or be ashamed. Kisse darna hai? Kyun darna hai? Baat hi to karna hai. It's okay if you make mistakes, because that's how you learn. You make mistakes and you learn. Just believe in yourself, have confidence. And let me tell you, there is no one way to speak the language, any language. You speak, you learn, and you improve. That's how you do it. Number 2, don't get frustrated. Don't give up. There'll always be 100 people mocking at your language, but that's not important at all. What's most important is to have patience. Be patient with yourself. Don't hurry. Have you seen those huge hoardings that says learn English in 2 weeks, learn English in 1 month? No, I mean, are you serious? Do you really think you can learn English in 2 weeks or 1 month? You tell me, how long did it take for you to learn your mother tongue? Definitely not 2 weeks, right? So give yourself some time. Don't be in a hurry. Language is easy, but like everything else, it's perfected with time. So give yourself that space, give yourself that time, have patience and never give up. Number 3, never ever compare yourself with a native speaker. I remember as a child, I have always wanted to be Hermione Granger, speak like her. But it's funny, we can never speak like another person, it's not possible. Everybody has a different dialect, everybody speaks a different way. You can never be someone else. So what you have to focus on is speaking the language right, is to get the language right and nothing else. And let's all come to a mutual understanding that English is not native anymore. It is a global language, everybody speaks it. So what's important is to be comfortable in your own accent. What's important is to speak right. Number 4. Even though you think you're fluent in the language, don't stop learning. Keep learning. Someone great once said that there is no end to learn. My granddad is an English scholar, and today when I have conversations with him, it's hard for him to understand half the things that I speak. And that is because time changes. You need to evolve with the time. You need to keep learning. And something like language, which is limitless, it's hard to get it perfected. And so keep moving, keep learning. I have a friend who studied in Germany for 2 years. She came back to India for an interview and guess what? She didn't clear it. She didn't clear it because her English wasn't good enough. And that's exactly our point, our last and 5th point, that don't take long breaks. The reason why she lost touch with English is because in a country like Germany, you tend to speak their native tongue more than you speak English. And this could happen to a lot of us when we go outside to a different country or a different state where you get to speak their native tongue. We usually forget the language English. We should not make this mistake. This is our final don't. So what do you do at times like this? You surround yourself with people who speak English. And when that's also harder for you, surround yourself with English materials, like watch English movies, listen to English music, listen to English podcasts, read English novels. But don't take a break, because that will never help you. So now we come to the end of the video. Let's look at our 5 don'ts again. Number 1, fear. Don't be afraid. Number 2, don't get frustrated and give up. Number 3, never ever compare yourself to a native speaker. Number 4, even though you think you're good at English or fluent at the language, keep learning, don't stop learning. And number 5, don't take long breaks. With these 5 don'ts, I'm pretty sure you'll be able to improve your fluency in the language English. Stay tuned for more informative videos from English Partner with Sanjana. Bye-bye!